Hello friends, welcome back to my channel, and today we are back with another exciting video. So in this tutorial we are going to talk about deploying a Java based application using Docker and Kubernetes. So we will see like a Java based Spring Boot or any kind of Java based application, how you can deploy that application into Kubernetes cluster. For that, you know, you need to do a Dockerization of your application into an image. You need to have a Maven build or some Granite build. So all those things we will discuss it. So what we will do is like this will be a good tutorial for Java developers. So if you want to understand how you can deploy your application to Kubernetes cluster, what we want going to see in this tutorial will be, we will be seeing how to build your Java application using Maven first, because you need to build your jar file or var file using Maven build. So we'll build your basic Java application, and we will get the target jar file from it, and then we will containerize that jar file, and you will put a Docker file so that we'll write those contents. So we will containerize that application and we'll put it into a Docker file. So once you build it, you will get a Docker image, and that image we will deploy to Docker Hub, so that you know we can use that Docker image for future purpose. Now using that Docker image, we'll be deploying services and deployments in the Kubernetes cluster, so that you know we should be able to access your Java-based application using a web browser. So that should be your overall process in this Kubernetes tutorial for Java developers, or how to deploy your Java application using Docker and Kubernetes. So let's get started on that. So before I get into the actual demo on how to do that in a cluster environment, writing the YAML file, building, you know, setting up your Maven and all those things, I would request you, like, if you are new to my channel or if you have not subscribed to my channel, click on the subscribe button. Also like my video, share, and give your feedback in the comment section. So in order to deploy your Java application on Kubernetes, there are the process how we would like. I want to show it like a workflow. So how we will do it, like, you know, you consider you're a web developer, and you know you have GitHub where you'll be storing your all code, right? So as a developer, you'll be committing your code to Git repository. So you'll have your Java project. So in this tutorial we'll be using a sample project. We'll have like a microservice. We'll have different routes, so we'll talk about that a little bit. So but this code is available in GitHub. So from GitHub you'll be checking out for that code, right? And what we will use it is that code is a base code, right? You don't have the target file like .jar or var file. So you need to build your code to convert that into the jar file. So we'll be using Maven build. So we will use Maven to build your application. So once you build the application, you'll be getting, you know, a jar file, and using that jar file we'll be using a Docker build, so that you know we can build your Java or Spring Boot application into a Docker image. So in this Docker build process, we'll be having Docker files. So we'll use Docker file commands, so that you can copy the jar file into the Docker image, so that once you run the Docker image as a container, we should be able to access your application, right? So once we build your Docker image, what we will do is we need to push the Docker image to Docker Hub, right? So because we need some repository where we can store our Docker image, because if you keep it inside your local machine, you alone will be able to access it. But if you push it to Docker Hub or some Docker repository, whether it can be GitLab container registry or it can be your own repositories, once you push it, you know, you have that Docker image in the Docker Hub. So what we will use is, using the image in the Docker Hub, we'll be deploying the application into Kubernetes cluster. So it can be a mini cube or it can be a multiple nodes cluster. So in this tutorial we'll be use a mini cube setup, so we can easily use that mini cube to deploy our deployments and services in the mini cube cluster. So that will be the overall flowchart or the things which we are happening, and all these steps we are going to do manually, so that you can understand what is the process we are doing. And there are a lot of prerequisites we need to set up before we can do all these things. And you may be thinking like, why we have to do manually? Why can't we do a CI/CD process where we can have Jenkins or some kind of a continuous integration process so that we can be done automatically, right? Yes, that should be our next step. But if you need to understand what we are doing actually, the process, this process is going to be same whether it's a different kind of Java application. Anyhow, this you are going to do the same kind of process. So let's do this process so that you can understand the concept and how we are doing it. Then we can convert that into a Jenkins pipeline so that you just need to click one click. So it will do all these things automatically from its end itself. So in order to deploy this Java application to Kubernetes, there are some prerequisites which you need to be aware of, like, you know, you need to have a Java application or base code, right? So I'm not going to show you how to develop a Java code in this tutorial, because this is more about how to deploy your application into Kubernetes cluster, right? So this is not for deploying or creating a Java application. So if you want to have a microservice setup, or you know, or how to develop your Java application, you need to do that as part of separate course. Now you also need to have a Docker installed you know, in one of the machines, so that, you know, basically when you have a Kubernetes cluster, you should have Docker or Containerd or some kind of, you know, installation there. So in our case, we need Docker because we need to build our Docker image, we need to push it to Docker Hub, we need to run containers, right, to test it. So all those things we have to do it using Docker. And you need to also have a Kubernetes cluster, because ultimately at the end we need to deploy our microservice Java application into a Kubernetes cluster, right? And in order to do all these things, you should have a basic knowledge on Maven, because we have to do a build on Maven. So there are different kind of lifecycle in Maven where you need to know, like when you run MVN clean or you know, MVN install, what it does. So you need to understand Maven a little bit, and you also need to have some understanding on Docker so that you can write Docker files, you can build the Docker image. So, and you also need to have a understanding on Kubernetes so that, you know, you can write down your service YAML file, deployment YAML files, you know, why, what is this all about. But I'll be also explaining you all this thing, what we are doing as part of each component. When you're writing Docker file or Kubernetes and all those things, I will show you, you know, what we are doing. And if you don't know how much about Docker or Kubernetes, I have a complete playlist on that, and I have full courses on Docker, Jenkins, Kubernetes. So you can refer that and you can go through it to have a complete understanding on those topics as well. So we are getting started with the project. So I have a project in my GitHub, which is called Docker Java Kubernetes project. And there I have this application, Java application, which I have used from you know, O'Reilly project from Daniel Bryan. So I have not used the exactly, you know, the whole content from his GitHub. I have used the application alone, where it have three, you know, microservices, like, you know, it have a product catalog page, it have a front end page, and it have a stock manager page, right? So these details it have it. So using that, we are going to use this application into our overall process. Okay, so if I go to, you know, the application wise, so you can see it have a pom.xml file, right, where it's have the complete details on the pom.xml. It have also like a different src file, configurations, you know, the Java code, right, this java file. And you know, they have all these details, like as I mentioned, have three, you know, microservice components, like one is one product catalog, other one is shop friend, and the stock manager, right? And I will talk about this Docker file a little bit later. So but I just want to show you what is this project about. So these are the three components what we are going to do. And I also have this Kubernetes cluster where I am having Docker installed, and I also have Git installed. So you can, because we need the Git to clone our project from GitHub. Okay, if you don't know how to install Git, you can use yum install git. Okay, you can start the minikube using minikube start driver. So I'm just starting the minikube. So once again, like if you don't know how to set up minikube, I have a separate video on my channel which talks about how to set up minikube. I also have video on how to set up Kubernetes cluster where you have a master and nodes, multiple nodes. I also have videos on how to make use of K8s, so which is also like a containerized version of your Kubernetes cluster. So there are different kind of tutorials which you can use to set up a Kubernetes cluster, and you can use any of those for this tutorial as well. So you can see Kubernetes cluster is up. So if I go to kubectl get cluster info, so if I run kubectl cluster info, you can see it's showing the details on what is the Kubernetes control plane, kubedns, which is running as minikube, right? Now what we need to do is we need to have Maven installed. So you can use simply like yum install Maven, and it should install Maven. Okay, so once you install Maven, you also need to set up configurations, because you need to set the Maven home page. So I will show you how to set that, and once you set that, you can you should be able to use Maven to build your application. So since I already have installed Maven, so it says Maven is already installed. Now what you need to do is you need to set the Maven environment variable. So if you see Maven MVN -- version, you should be able to see the Maven install, right? And you have the Maven home as user share Maven. So you need to export that as an environmental variable. So you can set like export Maven home _ user share Maven. So what it does is it will set the Maven home as a variable, so you can call that and they should be able to give this output, right? And you can also set this in the profile page so that it can do it every time, even if you reboot your machine. So now the Maven is set up, right? So the Maven installation is pretty simple. You can just set up using yum install Maven, and you just set the Maven home. So once that is done, now we are ready to build our application, right? So what we need to do is we have our application, which have the product page, shop front page, stock master, right? Now let's little bit go through this Docker file. Okay, the Docker file is also pretty simple concept, because what we are going to do is we are going to call a base image for OpenJDK JRE file, right? And we are going to add a target, means we are going to copy the app dot you are going to copy this jar file. Once you build your product catalog, you are going to get a jar file like product catalog 00.snapshot.jar, and we are going to use that into app as a app dot jar, right? And we are going to add a YAML file called product catalog.yaml, and that will define your whole configurations over here, right? Like what do you have to do, like what is the HTTP, what the port number, and all those things are defined here. You can also define it directly here, and then you can expose the port 8080, and we are going to use the entry point as Java, and we are going to run the app.jar file using this app config, right? So now that's a pretty simple, and this is the same thing which we are doing for other files as well. We are just going to copy the jar file and to the image, and we are going to run as an entry point. So the port numbers are different for each microservice. So as when you build your application, it's going to create a jar file over target folder. So I will show you all those things. So if you try to create an image before building it, it will tell you the message like the jar file is missing. I will show you that as well. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this link for my GitHub, and I'm going to clone that project into my Kubernetes machine. Okay, so it's cloning. So now you can see I have this folder. So if I go inside, I have different kind of folders, right? Product catalog, shopfront, stock master, right? So if I go to shopfront, and I have this Docker file, POM file, SRC, right? There is no target folder. Now if I try to, before building, I have to build my application to get the target, right? Let me also show you, like if I go to Docker images, I don't have any Docker image for any customized Docker image for this application, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a image first. So what I'm going to do is Docker build hyphen t, and I'm going to call this image as shopfront. Usually this is a sample one, okay? Don't take it exactly this, because when you try to push it to Docker Hub, you need to give also your ID or the username for Docker Hub so that it can push it to that. If you don't give that, it will not be able to push. This is a sample one, so I'm just trying to give a shopfront, and I'm going to, this Docker file is in this current location, so I'm going to give a dot, right? So now if you see, I tried to run it, so it has used this OpenJDK file, and it's trying to add the target like a snapshot.jar, and it says file not found, right? So this file is not available inside target folder, right? So the target folder itself is not there. So because of that, this exclude or error exit this build process. So you need to have the file before we can build our application. So now let me build our application first. So in order to build a Java project using Maven, we can use commands like maven clean install, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this command inside this folder, because this pom.xml and everything is inside this shopfront, and I'm inside that folder. So I'm going to run maven clean install from inside that folder, so it can build that part of our microservice alone. Now you can see it has started the building process. Now when you're doing this process using CI/CD Jenkins or something, we are going to call this building process inside the our pipeline, right? So we are going to use inside the pipeline to build this jar file, so it will automatically do that. We'll see that in the upcoming tutorials, but this one I just want to show you what we are actually doing. We are trying to build our application using maven clean. Now we can see the build is success, right? And it's has created a shop .jar file, right? So if I go and let me clear out the screen, and if I go and check it, now we have a folder called target here. So if I go to target and if I check it, you can see there is a file called shopfront.jar, right? So now this file is there, so it should be able to use that file to build our Docker image, right? So now if I use it, I will use docker build hyphen t, and I need to give the name of my Docker Hub account. So my name Docker Hub account is tips for you, and I'm going to use slash, and I'm going to give this image as shopfront and latest, the tag is latest, and I'm going to use the current folder where the Docker file is there. Now if I build it, you can see it is doing the process. So now it has completed the build, and you can see it has created a few layers, right? It has used the OpenJDK base image, it has added the target, and it has exposed the port numbers, it has created a container, intermediate container, and it had also created the entry point, right? So now if I go back and if I go to Docker images, you can see I have a new image called tips for you shopfront latest, right? And the image ID is this, just created 24 second ago, right? Now what I want to do is I want to do the same thing for other microservice as well. So now if I go, I have one for product catalog, right? So if I go to product catalog, I have a similar kind of Docker file, pom.xml, catalog.yaml, src file, right? I want to use maven clean install here, so it can build the application and it can give the .jar file. So let's wait for the build process to be completed. Now we can see the build has completed here as well as success. So I will clear out the screen. Now we can see I have also have a target here. So, and inside the target we have this product catalog dot snapshot dot jar, right? So I will exit from here, and let me do a Docker build. So I will use Docker build hyphen t, and I need to give the name of my Docker Hub account. So it should be the tips for you slash, and I want to give the name for this image, and I'm going to call the image as latest, right? Sorry, I have missed the dot, because we have to give the path where the Docker file is there. So now it has built the container for product catalog as well. So you can see we have created the container. So if I go to Docker images, you should be able to see one more image called the product catalog, right? So it has created the next image. So let me go back again, and I have the next one, which is called Stock Master. So if I go to Stock Master, and if I do a MVN clean install, it should build the node jar file for this microservice part as well. Now you can see this build is also completed, right? So if I go back, you can see there's a target folder, and if I go to target, you should be able to see the file .jar file, right? So I will exit from here and let me clear out the screen. So I want to build the image from using the .jar file, so I will use Docker build again, -t and the tips for use / stock manager latest and dot, so where the Docker build file is there. Now you can see we have built three images, right? So we have three images now. One is Stock Master, one is for product catalog, one is Shopfront, right? And all these names, if you see, start with the tips for you, because that's the username for my Docker Hub. So if you don't give that name, you will not be able to push your image to, you know, Docker Hub, because it has to understand from which account this has to be pushed, right? We are going to log into that account first. Now let's do that login, and we have to push it. So for that, you need to use Docker login. And you know, once you log in, it will ask you for the user ID. So I will give the tip for you, and I'm going to give the password. So now you can see it has mentioned like login succeeded, right? So I'm inside, I've logged into Docker Hub. You know, login from this machine, and I have Docker images. Now what I want to do is I want to push this Docker image, right? So if I use Docker push, and I will give the image name. So I will use Docker push and Shopfront. So now you can see it is pushing the image to my Docker Hub. Okay, so this may take time based on your informations. So how much you know, the data it has to push it. And I'll just exit. So also one thing you need to do is when you push it, you give the tag as well. So I will give latest, because I want to put this image as the latest tag. So I'm going to push that again. So now you can see it is trying to push it, and you know, based on the image size, it will push the images to the Docker Hub. I will skip this step, because I already had pushed these images to Docker Hub. So the steps is simple. I already logged in to the Docker Hub, and I'm going to Docker push, and I'm going to give the image which I created with the tag, right? So since I already pushed it, you can see if I go to my Docker Hub login, you should be able to see the images which is already available, right? In your repository. So now you can see I have Shopfront, Stock Master, and product catalog, right, which is 7 days ago, because I already pushed it some days before for from all these images. So I don't want to spend more time pushing it again with a different tag, or you know, overwriting it, because it does not make any sense for me to use that bandwidth and sending it to the Docker Hub again. So yeah, only thing is I want you to understand how to push it. So once you push it, you should have it in your Docker Hub. So once that is done, you can Docker log out, so that you know, you can log out from the Docker Hub login from your system. Now we have the basic requirements which we need to deploy for our Kubernetes cluster, right? So we have our Docker images ready in the Docker Hub. Now what we need to do is, if I go back to my application, I have a folder called Kubernetes, right, where I have defined a few YAML file. So in this YAML file for Shopfront, what we have done is we have two sections. One is for service, and other one is for deployment, right? So if you don't know about deployment services, replica set, you know, all those things, if you don't know, I would say like you have to refer Kubernetes tutorial first, which I also have completely defined and explained in my tutorials, which I will refer, give it in the video description of the Kubernetes playlist, which you can refer. Okay, so there I have explained how to write this manifest file, right? So what we are doing, we are writing this manifest file where we are using the API versions. We are defining the kind, whether it's a service or is it a deployment, and we are defining the metadata, where the name of this service, which should be shopfront, and the label. The label is very important because you know, the label matches has to be done in order for the pods to be mapped to the services or deployment, right? So we are using app shopfront, and here at the spec, you know, we are going to use node port, and you know, the selector is also app shopfront and the ports. So we are going to use port 8010 and you know, name HTTP. And if you see this second part, which is the apps slash v1, and the kind is deployment. So we are going to use deployment as well, because service alone cannot run, because this deployment has to be created, which create pods, and you know, this deployment has to be converted or exposed to using service, right? Okay, so now here also we are using metadata as name as shopfront, and we are using the match label selectors here, and you know, the replicas, we are going to use only one replica in this tutorial because I'm using a minikube. If you have more you know, system resources like CPU, memory, you can run more replicas as well. Now we have this template where the match label is app shopfront, and we are using the container name as shopfront. And this is important because the image, now this image what we are using is tips for you shopfront latest, right? This is should come from the Docker Hub. If you have not pushed it to Docker Hub, this will not work. And also if you see, this name has to match exactly what you have pushed to Docker Hub, right? If you don't give tips for you in your, when you're pushing, it will not push to your you know, login, because it has to be going to your login, which we are calling in our deployment. And it's a container port is 8010, and we are also using a liveness prop to just check the health, right? The initial delay is 30 seconds and timeout is 1 second. The same concept which we are going to use for product catalog and also stock manager, right? We are using a service and deployment. The only difference is we are using a different image. So here this is a different image from product catalog, and here if you see the stock manager, we are using a stock manager image, right? The port numbers are different as well. So I have shared all these things in this in my GitHub links, which I will give it to the video description, so you can check this YAML file over here, the Kubernetes folder, where you can refer it. Okay, so what I want to do is I have all these files inside now. If I go back one folder up, you have a folder called Kubernetes, right? Now I have all these folders, all these YAML files or manifest file in this folder, right? Now I need to apply this YAML file so that, you know, it can create the deployment and services. Now if I go and show you like kubectl get pods, right? To get the pods running from the namespace, it's default namespace, so it does not have any pods, right? Now if I go to kubectl get deployments, you don't have any deployment as well. And if you see kubectl get svc or services, you have only one default services from the Kubernetes, right? So now what I want to do is I will clear out the screen, and I will list down this YAML file. Now I want to apply this one so that it can create our containers, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use kubectl or kubectl apply hyphen f, and I'm going to use the shopfront service.yaml first. So if I run it now, you can see it has created a service and also a deployment. So if I go to kubectl get deployment, now you can see it is creating our deployment, right? It's 0/1, so you just need to wait. And we go to kubectl get svc, you should see like there is a service called shopfront as well, right? And let me also see kubectl get pods. Now you can see it has a pod, no, shopfront pod, and it's also creating the container. So based on the container it is created, the deployment will also get up. Okay, so let's wait for this to be completed. So now we can see the pod is running, right? So if I just check the pod again, it's running. And if I go to my deployments, now you can see the deployment also 1-1 ready. And SVC, it's also should be all up, right? Okay, so now our first service and deployment from one of the microservice part is done. Now we need to apply the other parts as well. So if I go to kubectl apply -f, and I will do for the product catalog, and I will there is a typo here, it should be kubectl or kubectl. Okay, and I'm also going to do the same for the other one as well, for stock manager. So now we have kubectl get pods. Now we have other two more pods getting created, right? And kubectl get deployments. Now we can see the other three, there are three deployments, right? And the two of them are ready and one is still yet to be ready. So we have to wait for all these things to be ready. Okay, so let's wait. One container is still getting created, so we have to wait. So now we can see all the pods are running, so it should be all good now. So you can see all deployments are up as well. And if you go to kubectl get svc for services, or there are three services as well running now. So our deployment part is done now. So we have our three microservice setup running, right? And it's like as three separate pods, three separate deployment, three separate services, right? Now we need to access our applications through a web browser, right? So let me get the IP address and the port number for our service. So what you need to do is, for Shopfront is our main front end, so I will use Minikube service Shopfront, right? So it should give me the URL for accessing our application. So I will just copy this one and I will go to my web browser, and I'm going to put this IP address there. So now you can see our front end is up, right? So we have this Docker Java application where it's giving our product details, right? So this is running on this service. Now it's the same way, like if I go to Minikube service Shopfront, I go to the product catalog, it should give me this URL. So I will copy this, and if I go to the web browser, and this for this part you need to also give product, okay, because that's how the the configuration is done. It should be products, not product. Okay, so now you can see this details about the products are listed here, right? The name, description, all those things are here. And the same thing, like if I go back to Minikube service and if I get the IP address and port number for stock manager, and if I go to copy this, and if I use slash stocks, because the route is like that. So now we can see the stocks, it's also give you the details about the product ID, SKU, amount available, right? So it gives the complete details. So it's almost like all these three things are related, right? So it's running based on like a microservice model, right? Where we are running our application on Kubernetes cluster with different deployment, different services. You have the front end, you have the product page, we have the stock page, where all those things are related, and you should have the application running, right? So that's how the basic concept, like the Java application, it can be any kind of application, whether small or complex or different, Spring Boot, or it can be a different kind of Java application, whichever you want to develop. It's as a developer, you can do whatever you want and you can create based on your requirement. Now from a deployment part, what you need to do is the steps are same, okay? You need to have the files, the source code of your application. In that you need to use Maven, and you need to build your application using Maven build, and you need to convert your application into a .jar file, right? And you need to use that jar file and you need to create a Docker file so that this jar file can be copied and you can build an image into that, right? So that part has to be done, so that you need to write a Docker file in your location where these source files are there. Okay, so you can put that as well into your Git repository. So once that build is done, you have the jar file and the Docker file is run using Docker build, you have your image ready, right? So when you're creating the image, you need to have ID, the Docker Hub login map to it, so that it can push that into your Docker Hub, right? So in my case, I showed you three images are already pushed. So once you Docker Hub, you need to log into the Docker Hub and you need to push it to your Docker Hub. So once you have it in your remote repository or Docker Hub, it can be pulled in any place, right, or any machine. So that is where you have our YAML files for Kubernetes or service YAML file and deployment YAML file. So you need to write that based on your image, which image you want to use, right? So once you use that, and if you go to your Kubernetes cluster and if you apply those manifest file, it's going to create your deployments, pods, services, right? So all three services are created, all three deployments and pods are created as well. Then based on that, you should be able to access your application. So in your case, it can be one single image or it can be multiple image, like how we did it now. So it's up to you, like how you want to do it, but this is the concept. Now we can do this, all these things, into a automated way. What only thing is, we just need to convert all this manual stuff into a Jenkins pipeline script, where we need to call the Maven build, where we need to build your application or Docker image using Docker file. We need to push it to Docker Hub using Docker login, and you need to integrate with Kubernetes cluster so that you can apply or deploy your image into the cluster using service and deployments. So that is all for this. So I hope if you see, this is what we have done. We have done this all process of Maven build, creating Docker image, pushing to Docker Hub and deploying to your Kubernetes cluster. So we have shown all these steps, how to do it manually, and I hope it should be helpful for you to understand the concept first, how this is done using these command lines. And this you can do it in an automated way, any way you want. So that's all I wanted to show it in this tutorial. So I hope this tutorial is informative for you, and I hope in order to see more videos like that, I would request you to subscribe to my channel and also like my videos if you see that these videos are helpful for you, and also share with others and give your feedback in the comment sections. So thank you for watching.